please subscribe and don't forget to press the bell icon to get notified whenever we upload a new video.
Now is NALCO. It is at the high point of today's trading session as we speak, but remember the stock is off about 32% from its 52-week high after a stellar run that we saw over the last 1 year. So to discuss more about the aluminium prices, we have with us Mr. T.K. Chand, the MD of the company. Thanks a lot, Mr. Chand, for joining in. First up, you know, I'm taking a look at the aluminium prices. They're at $2,175 average price for 2018 so far, which is a near three-year high. Where do you see them headed going forward?
Yeah, aluminium prices, as you see that in quarter three, it was average is around 2,100. And in February month till now, average is around 2,185. And currently it is at 2,239. And mainly because of Chinese New Year, and that smelters are having adequate stock of aluminium, and global market position is also comfortable. Not much of the stress is there for pushing up the aluminium prices. But as we see that there is some increase in the input prices that would give the support to the aluminium prices, and after the Chinese New Year is over, probably the activities will pick up. So we expect that aluminium prices will move between 2150 to 2250. That is the range in which it will be moving. Right now it is 2239, and it may go a little up and down like that it would be.
Okay, superb. Hi, Mr. Chand. So the $100, the level that you're keeping aluminium prices at, that's 2150 to around 2250.
2250.
Yeah. All right. So, but you were talking about the input cost. I wanted to ask you on that front, what is the caustic soda prices? What was it, sir, in the last quarter? Currently, what are those prices? And also, Coal India has increased prices, right? Will that hurt you?
Yeah. Input price will definitely be a factor because caustic soda prices last year up to December, if you take the 9 month ending December, it was around 29,000 average. Yeah. And in this year ending December, the average was around 36,000. That means that is an increase of 17%. And right now in January, the prices are now at 39,000, again 8% increase.
Okay.
So, but we expect that right now with this price, it will slowly now moderate down. And even carbon prices like CP coke have increased. So while input prices are definitely increasing, and Coal India has also increased its price per ton around 200 rupees, but we expect that it will have an impact on us, but we are in fourth quarter, it will be getting moderated because in alumina, we are doing around 13 shipments, whereas in quarter three, we have done 8 shipments. That will help us. And in quarter three, we are due to lack of coal, we had to shut down one of our power unit, and we imported power from state grid,
which
costed us around 38 crore more, but that expenditure will not be there this time.
Okay.
That will also be helping us. And premium third quarter was going at an average of $80, but right now in the current average of NALCO is $85.
Okay.
So that will also help us. So these factors will be adding up, and
Mr. Chand,
trying to.
Mr. Chand, let's keep it simple. You've given us quite a few numbers over there. You're telling us that input cost, yes, they've gone up a tad bit. You're saying you're going to save out on that imported coal that you brought in because, you know, you had shut down one of your power units, but that will start. So 30 crores you'll save out there as well. Simple point, sir.
Yeah.
Aluminium EBIT, can it turn positive? For the last quarter, it was very, I mean, the EBIT loss was around 90 crores, and last few quarters it has been giving a loss. When can this aluminium EBIT turn positive, sir? Can you reduce the EBIT losses on the aluminium business?
Yeah, if you see the analysis, that 90 crore negative in aluminium segment was mainly due to 38 to 40 crore added because of the power purchase. If you deduct that thing, it will be around 30 to 40 crore, which is definitely much less than the last year's same period.
Correct.
And this year, we are expecting that realization from aluminium will be improving. Because in quarter four, the average will be more than the quarter three, because quarter three average of LME was 2100, and right now in February average is 2185. Similarly, premium also, there has been
increase of $5
in the premium. So there would be some mitigation of the thing. We have to see that how it is moving.
Okay.
All right, Mr. Chand. So that's as far as your aluminium business is concerned. Now let's talk about alumina. Remember, the price is being around $500 in November. In the second quarter, it corrected to about $337 per ton. Do you think it's bottomed out because it's risen from those levels, 337 to about 400 in February itself? What do you expect out there? And volumes, what kind of volume projections do you have for alumina going forward?
If you see NALCO's global tender average, alumina price was 470 in third quarter, because it moved from 402 to as high as 527.
Okay.
And right now, NALCO's average tender price is coming around 360.
Oh, no.
So here, one good thing that in quarter four is that two of the high-priced segment which could not be lifted in the third quarter, that is $502 per ton and $527 per ton, that have got lifted in quarter four.
Okay.
In quarter four, we are making 13 segments. So we expect that in aluminum segment, this will help us. And second thing is that we are also expecting that after this Chinese New Year is over, and upbeat activity starts in the market, maybe aluminium market will also show little upbeat.
All right. Very quickly, Mr. Chand, before we let you go, sir, what is the current cash balance that you have? You have paid a dividend of around 4 rupees 50 paise, I think, in the last week or so. So what is the cash balance? You have some expansion plans. Has any of that started, or is it still on the drawing board?
Already aluminium refinery, which we are we have planned, that is around 1 million ton. That all statutory clearances have come under the contracts have been awarded. So groundbreaking is starting next month. So that will get completed in 3 or 3.5 years.
Okay.
And that will give a substantial benefit to NALCO, because we are expecting a net profit of around 250 to 300 crore from that unit itself.
Okay, that's okay.
And, and caustic soda plant, which we have planned it with a joint venture with Gujarat Alkali, because caustic soda, as you know, is a very required commodity input. And that also, they are also land, water, etc., all of we have got, and public hearing is also over. And now packages have been awarded, so we are expecting that within the next 24 months, that also will be come to commissioning. So these are the some of the other units are also coming are on the pipeline.
Absolutely. All right, Mr. Chand, sir, thank you so much for joining in and giving us all those clarity.